Hey guys, Footy Manager TV here, and welcome to episode number 10 on my FIFA 15 Road to Glory career mode with Shrewsbury. It's been a few days since I've uploaded a video in this series, basically getting the Inter Milan career mode underway, which you guys seem to enjoy. The response has been very good, but of course, this series has been doing pretty well as well. I just wanted to get that two career modes. A lot of you like the career modes and want to see a big team, and I'm playing live games on that one for people wondering, because obviously I'm not to the games yet. So hopefully you will enjoy that career mode as much as this one. Obviously this is more of a longer term one, more of a challenge to it, but I noticed a lot of you guys are missing a big team. So yeah, I just want to let you guys know that, yeah, it's not going to be stopping this career mode for me having two series on both games, FIFA and Football Manager. It's a good mix. So we'll get into the first game here today against Bury away from home, looking to continue to win games because obviously we've set the bar high, the standard, the way we've been playing, sitting first, 4 points ahead of Portsmouth, I believe, who's in second. So a pretty good start to the season. So here, sets it up for Lawrence here, gets past nicely with the movement, tries a shot. Holy, what was that? How close? Liam Lawrence, he's been so good this season for me, but unfortunately, he couldn't score. We had a second chance there, but unfortunately, the left back, I think that was, getting forward, scuffed the shot. So unfortunately, we did not score there. Disappointing, especially from, yeah, Liam Lawrence's chance. It was a great strike and had another chance here, and this is at the end of the game. Absolutely nothing happened in this game, and it looks like it's going to end 0-0. They had one late chance, but again, defending from the free kick, which I find pretty easy. I'm pretty good at winning headers from set pieces. From corners and crosses, a complete different situation. But yeah, I'm not sure if anyone feels the same. I think it's fairly easy to defend from set pieces, set piece free kicks, like that from out wide. So I'm not sure. I'm not sure why the players there were congratulating each other. It was a pretty poor game, to be honest. Finished 0-0 and left much to be desired in this game. It was very disappointing, especially, like I said, from the standards. We have set high early in the season, winning games. We did have a couple of chances, and you saw from that Liam Lawrence strike, it was great. But you saw there as well the possession. See, even on world class, I struggle to get possession at this lower level. So some people say play on legendary. I can't even have the better of possession on world class, even though I am getting results. But here we did get that U Scout back, a Scouter future star, and Niklas Müller looks like an excellent type. I'm not sure if that's striker or attacking midfielder, because he's got like attributes in his strengths of an attacking midfielder would have, not a striker. So will be interesting where we play him. Then we got that guy, still don't know, Hique, not sure plays how to pronounce, sorry, his last name, so just going to call him Paul for now. So we got Paul and Niklas Müller in there, some, yeah, good youngsters. Next up, we have scouting reports back from the Republic of Ireland. I'm still looking, you'll see throughout this episode as well, I am still looking for some funds. I keep requesting funds and I keep lowering each time, and it doesn't look like I'm going to get much. I'll drop the asking by the end of the episode, I think like 400k or something like that. Not sure if that's got accepted yet. But anyway, yeah, I want to get that so maybe I can sign some players on a pre-contract in January. So obviously, I'm trying to be realistic here. I'm trying to be realistic, trying to scout like Ireland, and I'm not sure where else I've scouted. Yeah, Scotland. England, Ireland, and Scotland are the three places I'm scouting. So trying to be a bit realistic instead of like getting guys from like South America or something or other European countries. Yeah, being a bit realistic here in terms of scouting. So hopefully you think that's a good idea. Tuba Akpom is only 19, so we can't get him on a pre-contract, but he is listed for loan. Maybe he could offer for loan in January, but I don't feel we need another striker. We've got James Collins and Lee Kun Ho absolutely killing it, and Akpa Akpo coming off the bench. But look at this guy, Roldo Vosten. But yeah, those kind of players wouldn't want to come. Like Guai, if that's how you say his name, ex-Everton player. Yeah, they probably want too much wages. But again, it really depends. If we have the wages there, that's why I'm asking for money. If we have the wages there, we can actually sign them. In FIFA career mode, it's not as realistic. Like, the player doesn't take into account if he wants to join that team. And yeah, one kind of plan I want to kind of try and sign this Ibra Sakajaya. I have no idea how to say his name, but if I do sign him, I can like, yeah, put in the title, sign Ibra. We signed Ibra. And yeah, that video will probably get a lot of views. So yeah, I probably would sign him almost just for that reason, but hopefully he looks all right and we can sign him for another reason as well, that he will perform for us. But anyway, let's move on. Yeah, we could have our own Ibra. But Yes, he's obviously not as good. He's like 59 overall. But you can see the stats now. We are only 2 points ahead of Portsmouth. That's what I mean. We're dropping a little bit if you're thinking about the total position. But honestly, I don't care. Like, we're a really good position. If you see the difference from third and fourth, yeah, we're in a good position. Like, with our early season form, we're going to... Well, it's not for sure yet. It's just a great chance. You look at that. Yeah, Plymouth Argyle... Well, they're on 28 points. I mean, from our first position to fourth position. That's what I mean, the difference in points. Like, we've had a great start to the season. You look at wage budget. We don't have heaps to play with if I was going to sign someone. That's why I keep, looking to request for someone. Because we did have low expectations, I'll just fight for promotion. Because basically, we're playing that way right now. And you don't see, like, we're not going to drop. And our team's only getting better. I'll show you a squad report as well. Our best players are only getting better. Our younger players are getting better. We're not going to be dropping anytime soon. If anything, scarily, we'll only be getting better this season. We'll only be getting better, and we've been fantastic so far. But we've got to watch out for the current point in time. We don't drop off too much, because I can notice in the last couple of games I've been playing, it's a bit stagnant, not creating too many chances. I'm still defending well. I'm still not conceding too many chances, but also I'm struggling to maintain possession. So does that mean, is 4-4-2 maybe not good enough if I'm not maintaining possession? For me, a 4-4-2 is a good countering formation and countering tactic. And I suppose that's shown this year with the results. Most games I haven't dominated possession, and I've got the wins. I've got the result on the scoreboard. So we'll see either way. But you look at the strikers up front. You got James Collins, who's on full form, and he's 66. Then you got Lee Kun Ho this year's signing. They're both on full form, and he's rated 70, Lee Kun Ho. He's just killer with that pace. And here he is, the man I'm speaking about. He just finds his way past the defense, and that time he finishes. So easy for him to finish, well, any player really, because the goalkeepers are so poor. But he's just so quick, and dribbling is great. Just, I was gonna say smash it, but he didn't smash it. He just did it near post, and you'd expect that to be saved, really. What are the goalkeepers doing at this level? EA, you say you improve goalkeepers. Well, at least not the low-level goalkeepers. They don't look like goalkeepers. They look like outfield outfield players trying to be a goalkeeper. But look at that tackle from Goldson. He's going to be one of our better centre-backs and just players for the team in general. One of the better players in the team going forward. He's got great physicals, and they almost score there late in the game. We are so lucky. That's what I mean. We could have easily dropped the points there. We're far from dominating games. We're far from that, most definitely. And I've noticed some errors sneaking into my game. But again, it's that man, Lee Kun Ho. And that touch, off his chest, I believe that was. That was perfect, in his stride, fake shot. I wasn't sure it was going to work. You saw I went back in. That time I did smash it. And again, goalkeeper, no chance of saving that if he couldn't save the last one. And Kun Ho, come on, what a signing has he been. He's leading the goal scoring, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I just saw it before when I was playing. He's leading the goal scoring in this league, and he's just been absolutely fantastic for us. He's like the perfect signing you have to go for. Like, I've heard people saying they've signed him like for Champions League, or not Champions League, sorry, Championship level, and even League One Championship, 9 goals. So that's telling me he's going to be performing for the next couple of seasons. Because if we're being honest, on this current form, we are going to get promoted this season. We're too good, and guys like Lee Kun Ho and Collins up front, we're going to be scoring enough goals, and defensively, we don't concede too many chances. See, that's what I mean again. We only have 40% possession, but we do dominate the game kind of in other areas, like shots on target and all that kind of stuff. So we're cruising along well, but again, the board reject the amount. I'm not sure. I just keep rejecting it each time. Eventually, I'm going to go to like a low amount, like might go to 100k or something like that. And we still would put the fight for promotion. Wasn't sure about the cups because you don't know how far you're going to go. Drop to 600k here. Wait to see if that's going to be accepted. Because, yeah, any more, it won't make a huge difference. But here, we'll check out a squad ranking and squad report. Of course, Lee Kun Ho is going to be firing at the top. But another interesting one is Liam Lawrence. We'll look at him in the squad report as well. But he is second, which is really good. Second best player. Callum Burton, +3. He's only 18. Imagine if he keeps that form up. Maybe another +3 for the rest of the season. Because it's not even halfway yet, and he'll be great. or great development. Even Cameron Gayle, Connor Goldson, that's what I mean. Look at his physical attributes, good strength, good pace. Dimitriou, a solid left back, 24, can still increase. Aaron Wildick has been a solid centre midfielder this season. Liam Lawrence, he's only decreasing in his mentals, but the rest are increasing. It should be the opposite. He should be decreasing in his technical and physicals, but increasing in his mentals for an older player. But yeah, FIFA's just mixed up. But Lee Kyun-ho has had a fantastic season. He's even getting better. James Collins as well. They've both kind of averaged a goal every two games, which is, yeah, pretty good average for a striker. Bradley Phillips-Kirk, the youth player we signed up basically right away, has grown one. We're going to have to need a lot more of that. James Caton is an interesting one. I actually saw him on Football Manager the other day, and he was rated natural as a striker in no other position. So I'm not sure if FIFA has it wrong or if Football Manager does, and I'm leaning towards FIFA would. So where does he play in real life? Imagine he would play as striker because, yeah, in Football Manager, he only plays as a striker. He doesn't play as a left midfielder. So, yeah, if you watch these League 2 games or if you follow Shrewsbury, leave your thoughts on where he does actually play. Yeah, but he's a decent young player. We'll keep him for, I'm not sure if it'll be Premier League level, but yeah, we'll see how that stuff goes. And yeah, I was thinking there to translist one of the goalkeepers because obviously we have three. And obviously you have the young guy in. Yeah, he's the main. He's developing very, very well. So our two backup, even though they're better rated, one of them is going to go. They're both counted as backup because we want to develop our younger keeper. And you saw he was developing well. So that is basically it. You've got Kyman Anderson. I'm not sure if he'd be good enough. Alex Fletcher as well. But yeah, like I was saying, Callum Burton, 18. He's almost getting to the stage of those other goalkeepers and just much better rated. So he's going to be there for the duration of this career mode to be maybe realistic. And here we actually got a decent U Scout report here. We got two guys with the maximum 87 potential. And actually Sean McGee, he's got a better current overall, and he's 1 year younger than the other guy. So interesting. But yeah, if we're getting guys in those high 80s potential, of course, that's not going to be their actual potential. It might shorten down to maybe low 80s or high 70s. But that's good for this level and the best we can kind of get from a one-star scout. You can't expect to get, yeah, those 94 potentials. We did with that other guy, that Paul, in the U squad. There he is. If anyone knows, please tell me, because I want to pronounce his last name like Ihikwe, but I have no idea, honestly. Yeah, Ihikwe. I don't know, it sounds so weird to say his name. But either way, our U squad is looking all right so far, doesn't he? Especially we've got Muller and Paul there. They're two guys. One, obviously, we got from the Scout of Future Star in the EA Sports catalog or whatever the hell it's called. But Paul, we actually scouted him. So it's a pretty good effort. We've got decent guys from one-star scout, as I mentioned. But next up here, away against Burton. Going to this match, I thought this would be easy, even though it's away from home. And yeah, actually, when I was going to this match, I'm not sure if you can tell if I'm kind of hesitating here before clicking on to play match, but I was kind of thinking to sim the match, because of course this is a long series. Would you like me to sim some games, especially when it's a season, like the first season when I'm dominating and it's pretty obvious that I am going to get promoted this season? And I haven't, this is actually the last recording I have, and that's what I mean. If you haven't noticed me uploading a lot, I actually have to play it a lot because I do three games per episode, and that's probably, it takes up an hour of my time for that. And obviously I focus a lot on recording Football Manager and my new FIFA career mode with Inter as well. So yeah, keep that in mind. It takes basically an hour of recording to get the footage, and then I have to edit and do a commentary. So basically 2 hours, if people are wondering, for this series, it probably takes 2 hours work for an episode. And unfortunately here we get an injury to Gianelli, who has been a promising youngster for us this season. And going forward, I do think he can be part of the team going into the Premier League. You say that, he's only 55 overall, but he's going to be growing with us. I can see by the time maybe we get to Championship League One, he'll be in the high 60s. Because he's only 17. He's only 17 and he's a quick kind of player. He's pacey. So when he develops, like, he's got mid-80 speed attributes right now. Like sprint speed, that's what I was going to say. And unfortunately, we concede here. And it like says Bar, their team, Burton Albion. But yeah, like I said, Gianelli, if he gets to even, like, if he's a low 70s player, he'll still be good and hopefully get to mid-70s. Because he's got a lot of pace, and at his best, like I said, he's already got mid-80s, like, speed attributes, so they're going to go to the high 80s and maybe 90s if we're lucky, and he'll be one of those impact players. And luckily here, Ryan Wood's getting forward, and this guy, It seems as though every episode he scored a goal. I know he hasn't, but he just seems to make a good impact. He's just too quick there. You saw with the fake shot, just movement was too quick. And that was the end of the game, and to end this episode as well. And it was, again, another situation. We couldn't dominate possession. They had 62%. I don't know if it's just this formation, the way it's set up, and my custom tactics as well. It's for like a counter kind of style. And I guess, I don't know, you can say it works to get results. We're at the top this season, but we've got some injuries as well. Ginelli's injured for 3 months, so hopefully, yeah, that doesn't hurt his development. And I want to go far in the J-Paint Trophy. I want to win that this season. I believe we can. We're still first, but only 2 points ahead, so that's still playing on my mind a little bit. But anyway, if you want to see this series a bit more regularly, if you want me to try and get it out daily, I'll do my very best. Like I said, I need to record it more. Just, yeah, smash up the likes on this video. Try and hit 200. Subscribe if you haven't yet, of course. And I shall see you guys next time.